Introduction to Law for Science and Engineering. Rubel Mohammed School of Engineering and Material Science, Queen Mary University of London. Student ID 14034100 abstract. The following report will outline in detail the differences between the wrongful and unfair dismissal. In the UK alone, every year, thousands of dismissal claims are made every year. Case studies will be utilized to demonstrate how current regulations and legislations can be implemented in real-life scenarios. In addition to this, detailed explanations will be provided about various remedies available to the employee depending on the type of dismissal. Lastly, a step-by-step procedure will be outlined such that employee can make a claim against unlawful dismissal. Contents abstract. 11 Introduction. 21.1 Employment Law. 21.2 Historical Development. 21.3 Introduction to Dismissal. 22 Type of Employment Status. 33.1 Wrongful Dismissal. 43.2 Remedies for Wrongful Dismissal. 44.1 Unfair Dismissal. 54.2 Remedies for Unfair Dismissal. 85 Conclusion. 96 Cases. 97 Acts. 98 References. 10 List of Figures. Figure 1, showing the various way a contract can be ended. Figure 2, showing the various tests to conduct to check the status of an individual. List of Tables. Table 1, showing reasons for automatic unfair dismissal. Table 2, showing reasons for potential unfair dismissal. Table 3, showing reasons for automatic unfair dismissal. Table 4, showing the basic award calculation based on age. Table 5, showing factors that attributes to the compensatory award. Title of the essay: define what is meant by wrongful dismissal and by unfair dismissal and explain what the routes for seeking remedies are and what remedies are available. 1. Introduction. 1.1 Employment Law. Employment law is a branch of the law that regulates affairs among the employer, employee, and trade unions. It ensures that matters such as employment contracts, minimum wages, working hours, sick pay, holiday pay, redundancy, discrimination, disability, parental leave and any disciplinary processes are not unlawfully exploited. 1. This law facilitates the cooperation of three fundamental relationships: employee-employer, employer-trade union and trade union member. 2. In the past, employment law used to protect the employers from the employees, but in the modern society it is primarily operated to protect the employee from discrimination, health, and safety and to prevent work disruption for unfair reasons. When issues arise between the two parties, then an independent judicial body, the employment tribunal, analyses the situation and provide remedies to the damages occurred to the employee. 3.1.2 Historical Development. The very first law protecting the worker from the unfair dismissal was introduced in the UK about 40 years ago, 1963. 4. In particular, the Blue Metal v. Hughes case proposed the first feasible notice period required to terminate an employment contract. Such case led to the formation of three legislations that protects the worker from unlawful dismissal. The three acts are labeled as follows: Contract of Employment, 1963, Redundancy Payment Act, 1965, Industrial Relations Act, 1971. The Contract of Employment, 1963, was the first legislation that was produced from the Hughes case. This act states the minimum period of notice required between the employer and the employee before an employee can be dismissed. The second act, the Redundancy Payment Act, allowed the worker to receive a compensation network in case of job loss. The third act, mainly the Industrial Relations Act, 1971, protects the worker from unfair dismissal. This act is particularly important, as for the first time, it allowed the worker to appeal to the tribunal. 5.1.3 Introduction to Dismissal. Dismissal can be defined as the termination of the contract, performed by the employer against the employee, with or without providing valid justification. 6. This might lead to loss and damages to the employee. In fact, employment law requires the employer to follow a certain standard and procedure before terminating the employment contract, such that least amount of damage is affected to the employee. There are various ways to terminate a contract as shown in the image in Figure 1 underneath. Figure 1, showing the various way a contract can be ended, Employee Rescue, 2018, 72. Type of employment status. Employment law can be ruled only when an individual is actually an employee of a company. It is required to identify and define whether an employee is a worker, a self-employer or a subcontractor. According to the ERA 1996, S.230, 1, the employee is defined as following: an individual who has started work or worked under a contract of employment. 8. In order to make any claim for wrongful or unfair dismissal, the worker must be a fully qualified employee. Apart from this, there are other benefits that employee can claim, such as protection right, sick pay, holiday pay and many more. To determine the status of the employer, several tests can be conducted. These tests are: integration test, control test, economic reality test, mutuality test and multiple test as shown in Figure 2. Figure 2, showing the various tests to conduct to check the status of an individual. 9. Depending on circumstances, the type of job and the nature of the work, these tests can be implemented to assess the nature of the employment. In some cases, multiple tests needs to be carried out, which consists running all the tests mentioned above together. 3.1 Wrongful dismissal. Wrongful dismissal is a type of dismissal that occurs when the contract is breached. In order for a dismissal to be wrongful, the following conditions need to be met: 1. No prior or sufficient notice has been provided by the employer to terminate the contract. 2. The employer has not provided a valid reason for termination of the contract. The length of the notice period depends on the contract and on the nature of the job. This can be agreed between the employer and employee when signing the contract. However, if this is not explicitly stated, then the common law states to imply a minimal period of reasonable notice, which is reliant on the circumstances of the employment in question. 10. However, recently the common law has changed the regulation regarding the minimum period of notice. The current legislation states that if the length of the employment is between 1 week and to 2 years, then the notice period should be 1 week. If the length of the employment is more than 12 years, then the notice period should be 12 weeks. Hence, it is possible to state that for every year of employment there is a week of the notice period is added. In addition to this, it is worth mentioning that the notice period also depends on the level of the employee. In fact, a senior employee can demand more prolonged period of notice. 11. When this occurs, the employee can take the case to the employment tribunal. The employment law facilitates the assessment in tribunal by analyzing the employment contract and current legislation. Hence, it required to assess whether such contract was breached. However, in some cases, the employer can dismiss the employee without any prior notice. Such condition is known as summary dismissal. This occurs when the employee commits gross misconduct such as theft, criminal act, and acts that are against the conventional norm. 12. A worth mentioning case is the case Hanley v. Pease, 1915. Where the employee was dismissed for being absent from work without authorization from the employer. Since no clear agreement was made in the contract regarding the suspension, the employee managed to obtain the salary for the day. In this case, the employer could have simply dismissed for the reason mentioned above, but an unpaid day helped the employee to win the case. 13. 3.2 Remedies for wrongful dismissal. The employee can claim damages for wrongful dismissal. However, no damage claim can be claimed if the employee was dismissed for gross misconduct or gross negligence. Damages caused by the wrongful dismissal are usually calculated based on the pay rate of the employee. There are two types of damages can be demanded: lost in salary, working days that employee can claim if the dismissal did not occur in the first place, and lost in work day due to notice to quit, loss in working days due inappropriate notice period. 14. To make these claims, cases needs to be taken to the tribunal. Generally, a tribunal consists of three core: individual, the employment judge, the employer expert, and a worker form the union. 15. Before proposing to the tribunal, the employee must contact the Advisory Conciliation and Arbitration Service, ACAS. This is the first stage where the employee and the employer can come to an agreement without the intervention of the court. The employment tribunal can make only claims that are no more than £25,000. For any amount above this threshold, claims need to be approved by the High Court. 16. There are some advantages to take the case to the High Court. Firstly, an employee can have up to 6 years to make a claim. Secondly, High Court civil procedure is utilized to maintain the claim. This means that the losing party will have to pay the legal fees for the winning individual. 17. Analyzing the Smith v. Trafford Housing Trust case, it is possible to observe that such damages can be low. In this case, a housing trust humiliated a manager for making comments about opposing gay marriages in church on his Facebook page. For this reason, the worker claimed for damages for wrongful dismissal by utilizing the case of Hogg v. Dover College. 18. This case is particularly important as the employer agreed to a new contract after a demotion. Hence, the damage paid in this case was the difference between the contractual salary and the new role, which was £98. Another worth mentioning case is the Malik v. Bank of Credit and Commerce International, BCCI, where the employee was working for a fraudulent bank and it was eventually shut down. After closure, the worker had difficulty to find an alternate job in the same industry due to the previous reputation. For this reason, a case was made against the employer due to economic loss caused by the wrong reputation. 19. Injunction. An alternative to damage. An alternative remedy for damages is injunction. Injunction can be defined as an order from the court that persuades or forces the employer to continue with the contract. Injunctions are approved or requested by the court in rare cases when it is difficult to establish a feasible solution to the case. If the circumstances allow, the court needs to grant an injunction as a remedy for the wrongful dismissal. An injunction, in order to be effect, must follow the following conditions. Damages would not be an alternative remedy, e.g. employee working in health sector, there must be reciprocal trust between the worked and employee such that employment relationship is not weakened beyond repair. Employee must claim protection for statutory rights. 20. A worth mentioning case of an injunction is the Hill v. C.A. Parson and Co. Ltd., where the employee, Mr. Hill, after providing 30 years of service decided to join a trade union not recommended by the company. For this reason, the worker was dismissed with a one-month notice. Consequently, Mr. Hill claimed for the injunction. The court awarded him 6 months' notice before ending the contract. In this case, providing financial compensation would have been inappropriate since there is still mutual trust and confidence between the employer and the employee. 21. 4.1 Unfair dismissal. Unfair dismissal can be distinct as a statutory right, hence it occurs when there is a breach of the statutes. Unlike the wrongful dismissal, the fairness of the dismissal is judged based on the reason provided by the employer. This concept was first introduced in the Industrial Relations Act 1971 and is now endorsed by Section 94 of the Employment Rights Act 1996. Certain jobs, such as share fishermen, police service, and people who are employed outside the Great Britain like the armed forces and Crown employee cannot claim for the unfair dismissal. In addition, those in an illegal employment contract cannot make any claim. 22. In order to make claim for unfair dismissal, there are key three requirements that needs to be followed. Those requirements include being in contract during the dismissal, be employed for at least 1 year and claim the dismissal within 3 months from the dismissal date. 23. A dismissal can be refereed as fair when the employer dismisses the employee under the regulations provided by the Employment Rights Act 1996. Those conditions include, the employee fails to complete the job to the desired standard. This also implies not be able to adapt to new changes and integrating with co-workers. Persistent long-term illness that affects work performance, statutory restriction. Hence, if the employee gets dismissed for any of the reasons mentioned above, then unfair dismissal cannot be claimed. A compelling case is the Martin v. Yeoman Aggregates Ltd., E.D. 1983, where the argument between the employer and employee led to the dismissal of the employee. However, after a short period of time, the employer withdrew the dismissal when he was thoughtful and less angry. In this case, it is important to observe that the dismissal was mentioned in a moment of heat, hence, it was ineffective. 24. In contrast, discrimination or dismissal based on the age of the employee, for instance, is certainly unlawful. Age-related discrimination is regulated by the Employment Equality, Age, regulations. This regulation states the employee dismissed at the age below 64 can be claimed as unlawful. However, depending on the job circumstances, it can be fair to dismiss at a different age. A good example of this is the Payne v. Royal and Sun Alliance Group PLC case, where the employer provided a valid reason to the employee to retire on time. In fact, Mr. Payne's could retire at age 62 instead of 65 without any permission from the employer. Hence, the worker claimed both for unfair and wrongful dismissal. This is due to the breach of contract as well as breach of the statute. Since there is no legislation that allows early retirement, the Employment Tribunal agreed to keep the contract open. According to the Employment Rights Act 1996, the reasoning behind the unfair dismissal can be classified into three categories: automatically fair reasons, automatically unfair reasons, potential fair reasons. Automatically fair dismissal occur when the employee takes unofficial industrial action and hence threatens the national security. In this case, it is reasonable to dismiss the worker. Thus, unfair dismissal cannot be claimed. In contrast, automatically unfair reasons include a list of situations where the dismissal is unlawful. These conditions include automatic unfair dismissal, pregnancy-related issues, health and safety issues, e.g. unable to work due to the safety of the environment, spent conviction, trade union issues, fixed-time employees or part-time employees, regulations, contravention asserting a statutory right, Table 1, showing reasons for automatic unfair dismissal. 25. For the reasons mentioned above, it is not required for the employee to have 1 year of service, hence it can be taken into court for the claim. The potential fair dismissal, instead, is based on how the employer handled the dismissal. Examples of potential fair dismissal might fall in one of the following group: potential unfair dismissal, capability or qualifications, conduct, redundancy, statutory bar, some other substantial reason. Table 2, showing reasons for potential unfair dismissal. 26. The first in the list refers to the capability and qualification of the employee to perform the task at the desired standard. Statutory bar applies when the employee has no right to due to the expired work permit. Lastly, misconduct relates to the breach of the contract due to the break of the rules imposed by the employer. A worth mentioning case is the British Waterways Board, T/A Scottish Canals, v. Smith. In this case, the employee, Mr. Smith, was dismissed for publishing negative comments on Facebook about his work and his manager. In addition, he published pictures of himself consuming alcohol in the work environment. The case was eventually taken to court, and at the end Mr. Smith was dismissed due to the act of misconduct. This case demonstrates that action can be taken later for misconduct, and it is important to keep a social media policy. Other possible reasons for potential fair dismissal includes: 1. Refusal to an agreement to amend the terms and conditions when considered mandatory by the manager. 2. Employee unable to be employed at the termination of the fixed-term contract. 3. An individual external forces for the dismissal of the employee, e.g. a customer. 4.2. Remedies for unfair dismissal. As a remedy for unfair dismissal, the following can be granted by the court: remedies for unfair dismissal, compensation, reinstatement, re-engagement declaration. Table 3, showing the remedies available for unfair dismissal. 27. Compensation occurs when a monetary payment is provided to the employee for the unfair dismissal. Reinstatements refers to the reallocation of the employee to the previous job such that the employee was never dismissed. Re-engagement, similar to reinstatements, offers the employee its previous job, but with different role or conditions. Compensation is calculated mainly in two ways: basic award and the compensatory award. Basic award is calculated as follows: basic award calculation, if over age 41, entitled to have 1.5 weeks pay for every year of service. If age between 22 and 41, entitled to have 1 week's pay for every year of service if age between 18 and 22, entitled to have 0.5 weeks pay for every year of service. Table 4, showing the basic award calculation based on age 28. There is a limitation in this which consists in receiving a maximum of £280 a week for 20 years of work. This implies that the maximum compensation granted for unfair dismissal is £8,400. Nevertheless, the number has now changed to £489 weekly if the weekly gross exceeds £489. This will only apply if the dismissal was caused after April 6, 2017. The compensatory award, in contrast, is not fixed and is based from case to case. Ref. In this compensation, financial compensation of up $80,541 for dismissal after April 6, 2017, is provided due to the loss caused by the dismissal. Calculations are based on the factors mentioned in Table 5, compensatory award loss of earning, i.e. due to the dismissal, loss of future earning, i.e. losses after the hearing, any expenses, i.e. to find alternative jobs, loss of statutory rights, e.g. unable to claim sick pay, loss of pension rights. Table 5, showing factors that attributes to the compensatory award. 29. This compensation, however, might be reduced if the employee contributed to the dismissal, failed to source alternative jobs or claimed benefits after the dismissal. 35. Conclusion. Overall, any employee after an unlawful termination of the contract has the right to claim for either wrongful or unfair dismissal. It is critical to know the differences between the two before making any claim. Based on the damage, different remedies are available. For wrongful dismissal, damages and injunction are the possible remedies, while for unfair dismissal, compensation, reinstatement, re-engagement, or a declaration might be awarded to the employee. Decisions are made from case to case, on the nature of the job and by stipulating the true intention of the employer and employee. Word count, 2,986. Cases: Blue Metal v. Hughes Hanley v. Pease, 1915, The Smith v. Trafford Housing Trust, Hogg v. Dover College, Malik v. Bank of Credit and Commerce International, BCCI, Hill v. C.A. Parson and C.O. Ltd., Martin v. Yeoman Aggregates Ltd., EAT 1983, Payne v. Royal and Sun Alliance Group PLC, The British Waterways Board, T/A Scottish Canals, v. Smith 7. Acts: Redundancy Payment Act 1965, Industrial Relations Act 1971, Industrial Relations Act 1971, Employment Rights Act 1996, Equality Act 2010. 8. References. 1. CIPD 2018, Employment Law CIPD. Online available at https://www.sip.co.uk/knowledge/fundamentals/emplaw/access January 18, 2018. 2out-law.com 2018, Trade Union Act ballot thresholds in force from March 1, regulations confirm. Online available at https://www.outlaw.com/n/article/2017/february/trade-union-act-ballot-thresholds-in-force-from-1-march-regulations-confirm/access-january-18th-2018 3acas.org.uk 2018, Employment Tribunals ACAS Advice and Guidance ACAS. Online available at http://www.acas.org.uk/index.aspx?article ID=sign1889 access January 18, 2018. 4. Anon, 2018. Evolution of the Employment Law. Online available at acas.org.uk. 2018, Employment Tribunals ACAS Advice and Guidance ACAS. Online available at http://www.acas.org.uk/index.aspx?article ID=sign1889 access January 18, 2018. Access January 18, 2018. 5. 5morton-fraser.com. 2018, History of Employment Law. Morton Fraser Lawyers, Edinburgh and Glasgow Estate Agents Wealth Managers. Online available at https://www.mortonfraser.com/knowledgehub/history-employment-law. 0 access January 18, 2018. 6gov.uk. 2018, Dismissal, Your Rights, gov.uk. Online available at https://www.governmentuk/dismissal access January 18, 2018. 7 Employee Rescue. 2018, Termination of Employment, Employee Rescue. Online available at http://www.employeerescue.co.uk/advice/your-employment-contract/termination/access January 18, 2018. 8 Legislation.gov.uk. 2018, Employment Rights Act 1996. Online available at https://www.legislation.government.uk/ucga/1996/18/section/230 access January 18, 2018. 9 Introduction to Employment Law. 2018, online available at https://www.gmplus.coac.uk access January 18, 2018 10 Suave Attorneys. 2018, Reasonable Notice on Termination of Employment. Online available at http://www.swab.com.au/publication/publication/reasonable-notice-of-termination-of-employment-percent-sign-e2%sign-93-h access January 18, 2018. 11 Heald Solicitors. 2018, Notice Periods, Heald Solicitors. Online available at http://www.healdlaw.com/commercial-law/employment-law/notice-periods access January 18, 2018. 12 gov.uk. 2018, Dismissing Staff, Fair Dismissals, gov.uk. Online available at https://www.government.uk/dismiss-staff/fair-dismissals access January 18, 2018. 13 findlaw.com.au. 2018, Can I be suspended from work by my employer? Online available at http://www.findlaw.com.au/article/5181/can-i-be-suspended-from-work-by-my-employer.aspx access January 18, 2018. 14 Wrongful Dismissal. 2018, Cite a Website, Cite This For Me online available at https://uk.practiclaw.thomsonreuters.com/5-386-1008, transition type equals default and context data equals SC default, and first page equals true access January 18, 2018. 15 citizensadvice.org.uk. 2018, Understanding Employment Tribunals. Online available at https://www.citizensadvice.org.uk/work/problems-at-work/employment-tribunals/understanding-employment-tribunals/access-january-18, 2018. 16 Make a Claim to an Employment Tribunal, gov.uk. 2018 Make a Claim to an Employment Tribunal, gov.uk. Online available at https://www.government.uk/employment-tribunals. Access January 18, 2018 17 Court and Tribunal Fees, gov.uk. 2018 Court and Tribunal Fees, gov.uk. Online available at https://www.government.uk/court-fees-what-they-are. Access January 18, 2018. 18 Dismissed or Not Dismissed. New Law Journal. 2018 Dismissed or Not Dismissed. New Law Journal. Online available at https://www.newlawjournal.co.uk/content/dismissed or not. Dismissed. Access January 18, 2018. 19 House of Lords, Malik v. Bank of Credit and Mahmood v. Bank of Credit. 2018 House of Lords, Malik v. Bank of Credit and Mahmood v. Bank of Credit. Online available at https://parliament.uk/pa/ld19979/judgment/jd970612/malik01.htm. Access January 18, 2018. 20 Women's Aid. 2018 Getting an Injunction, Women's Aid. Online available at https://www.womensaid.org.uk/the-survivors-handbook/getting-an-injunction/. Access January 18, 2018. 21 Hill v. C.A. Parsons and C.O. 1972 Case Summary Web/Law. 2018 Hill v. C.A. Parsons and C.O. 1972 Case Summary Web/Law. Online available at https://webstroke.co.uk/law/cases/Hill v. C.A. Parsons C.O. 1972. Access January 18, 2018. 22 Dismissal, Your Rights, Unfair and Constructive Dismissal, gov.uk. 2018 Dismissal, Your Rights, Unfair and Constructive Dismissal, gov.uk. Online available at https://www.governmentuk/dismissal/unfair-and-constructive-dismissal. Access January 18, 2018. 23 Requirements for Unfair Dismissal. 2018 Requirements for Unfair Dismissal. Online available at https://www.lawtyacker.net/free-law-essay/employment-law/requirements-for-unfair. Dismissal Employment Law Essay.php. Access January 18, 2018. 24 Swarb.co.uk. 2018 Martin v. Yeoman Aggregates Ltd., ed. 1983, Swarb.co.uk. Online available at http://swarb.co.uk/martin-v-yeoman-aggregates-ltd-ed-1983. Access January 18, 2018. 25 Employment Tribunals, Automatic Unfair Dismissal, Trying to Assert a Statutory Right, Citizens Advice. 2018 Employment Tribunals, Automatic Unfair Dismissal, Trying to Assert a Statutory Right, Citizens Advice. Online available at https://www.citizensadvice.org.uk/work/problems@work/employment-tribunals from 29 July 2013/making-an-employment-tribunal-claim-is-it-worth-it/employment-tribunals-automatic-unfair-dismissal/employment-tribunals-automatic-unfair-dismissal-trying-to-assert-a-statutory-right/. Access January 18, 2018. 26 Potential Unfair Dismissals ACAS Advice and Guidance ACAS. 2018 Fair and Unfair Dismissals ACAS Advice and Guidance ACAS. Online available at http://www.acas.org.uk/index.aspx?article ID=4098. Access January 18, 2018. 27 Remedies for Unfair Dismissal and Redundancy. 2018 Remedies for Unfair Dismissal and Redundancy. Online available at https://www.lawtyacker.net/free-law-essay/employment-law/remedies-for-unfair-dismissal-and-redundancy-employment-law-essay.php. Access January 18, 2018. 28 Basic Award Calculation, 2018, online available at https://uk.practiclaw.thomsonreuters.com/1-200. 3157, transition type equals default and context data equals SC default, and first page equals true. Access January 18, 2018. 29 Calculating the Compensatory Award, Citizens Advice. 2018 Calculating the Compensatory Award, Citizens Advice. Online available at https://www.citizensadvice.org.uk/work/problems. At work/employment tribunals from 29 July 2013 /employment tribunals valuing a claim /compensatory award /calculating the compensatory award /access January 18, 2018. 30 Employment Tribunals, How to Work Out Your Compensatory Award If You Are Claiming Unfair Dismissal, Citizens Advice. 2018 Employment Tribunals, How to Work Out Your Compensatory Award If You Are Claiming Unfair Dismissal, Citizens Advice. Online available at https://www.citizensadvice.org.uk/work/problems at work/employment tribunals from 29 July 2013 /employment tribunals valuing a claim /compensatory award /employment tribunals how to work out your compensatory award if you are claiming unfair dismissal /access January 18, 2018.